I can only say congratulations, Juliana. A beautiful film. I think we're all awestruck by this amazing woman who's with us here today. We're very honored to have her. And thank you all for staying here for the Q&A. It's fantastic that you're all here. A warm welcome also to those watching from home. Please help me in welcoming to the stage our moderator, associate programmer at ITFA, Maria Campaña Ramia. And welcome back, Juliana. Our lovely translator who'll be helping us with the translation today. I know. Daniela Navarrete. Welcome. And last but certainly not least, the fantastic Carmen Aristegui. Maria, the floor is yours.
Okay, let's start. Well, thank you so much, Juliana, for such a great film. It's really an honor to have it in ITFA and to have you both here. So for the ones who are joining us because this is being streamed, I would like just to make a quick introduction and tell you who is with us tonight. Mexican filmmaker Juliana Fanjul. She studied documentary at the prestigious school AICTV in the School of San Antonio de los Baños in Cuba. She holds a master in cinema studies from the ECAL and the HED in Switzerland. Before directing Radio Silence, which premiered at the Zurich Film Festival, she directed Muchachas, Cuba Calling, and Si Seguimos Vivos. And currently, she is the coordinator of the documentary department in the AICTV. Carmen Aristegui, she is one of Mexico and actually Latin American leading journalists and opinion leaders. She's the anchor of the news program Aristegui of CNN en Español. And she writes regularly an opinion section in the newspaper Reforma. She also manages her own website, Aristegui Noticias, as you've already seen. And, well, she has received countless awards and honors, like the Premio Gabriel García Márquez, the Premio Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz. She's a Chevalier of the French Legion of Honor in France and the recipient of the German Cross of the Order of Merit. So she's our fabulous guest tonight. First of all, Juliana, I see your film, of course, as a very engaging portrait of a fantastic journalist, but it's not exclusively this. I also see it as a letter, a love letter to your broken country, written with despair, with pain, but also full of hope. So it's a film where you manage to express some of the most contradictory faces of Mexico through the experience of Carmen. So I wonder when and how she became a catalyst of these reflections. What brought you two together?
Thank you, Maria. I'm really happy to be here. Well, as the film says, it all started when the program that I used to listen ended suddenly in March 2015. I was actually premiering my first feature, and suddenly that voice just got silent. And in the country, because I was living in Switzerland, we were starting to know about this series of very violent events. Of course, the disappearance of the 43 students of Iguala was really shocking. Seeing this image that is shown in the film of this young student without his face was something that I couldn't really name. I lost the words. And I lost the words twice because her voice was the bridge between Mexico and this new country for me. And I got really mad. And so I decided to transform this energy into a creative energy and find my tools as a filmmaker and go to Mexico and look for her. And well.
And well, the film ends with a transition between Peña Nieto and López Obrador, like this third shift of power in the century in Mexico. And Carmen, your radio program goes back to the air. We assume that López Obrador is going to keep his campaigns, his promises of campaign of holding to freedom of speech and respect of journalists. But time went by, and now he's almost a year in power. And more or less starting in May, we already heard that he has been into critics and in confrontation with certain outlets. He even called the Reforma a political party. So not accepting really critics. So in the country where the lives of journalists are so much at risk, we know like that Mexico and Philippines are, according to the Committee to Protect Journalists, the countries in the world where it's the most dangerous to be a professional of communication. What happens when these as if the journalist became like the devil somehow? What happens when this comes from the government? This vilification of the profession.
Carmen, ¿entiendes lo que voy a repetir?
Bueno, creo que sí entendí.
Sí, vale.
Y si no, voy a contestar lo que sea.
Vale.
Si no, yo te lo digo en español.
Creo que sí entendí todo lo que dijiste. Lo que no me atrevo es hablar en inglés porque no quiero pasar aquí una vergüenza mayor. Los desafíos en este nuevo gobierno con el presidente López Obrador en materia de libertad de expresión están más en el territorio de su propia relación con los medios críticos.
The challenges of this new government in Mexico is basically from his own government with the critic media in the country.
El presidente López Obrador ha prometido que no ocurrirá un caso como el mío o como el de José Gutiérrez Vivo, que es otro caso conocido en México de censura.
He has promised that under his government it won't happen something like what happened with Carmen and with another colleague of her that was could you repeat the name? ¿Puedes repetir el nombre?
Gutiérrez Vivo.
Gutiérrez Vivo, he promised already that things like that won't happen under his regime.
Es decir, casos de censura directa en contra de periodistas en México.
So not direct censorship cases against journalists.
Creo que no ocurrirá lo que ocurrió con nuestros casos con Gutiérrez, con López Obrador. Creo que no va a ocurrir así.
I don't think it's not going to happen like that.
Pero sí creo que hay un tema importante que tú mencionas, que es la relación que tiene el presidente con algunos medios.
But I think it's important something that you mentioned, that is the relationship the president has with some of the media.
El presidente se ha referido a medios de comunicación en específico como si fueran adversarios.
The president mentioned some specific media as if they are an adversary, a counterparty.
Creo que se equivoca.
And I think he is mistaken.
Porque el presidente como político requiere un adversario.
Because the president as a politician needs an adversary.
Pero ese adversario no es la prensa.
And they are not the media.
¿El presidente ganó las elecciones de forma contundente?
The president won by far with the most votes.
¿Y sus adversarios políticos quedaron muy debilitados?
And the other parties were actually very much debilitated, minimized.
¿El presidente no se refiere al PRI, no se refiere al PAN porque quedaron muy debilitados y disminuidos?
The other two political parties, PRI and PAN, were very minimized with his victory.
Y pienso que el presidente ha decidido tomar como figura adversarial.
And I think that the president chose to take as the enemy.
Algunos medios de comunicación críticos.
Some of the critical media.
¿Es una ruta equivocada?
I think it's the wrong way.
El presidente y la sociedad mexicana tienen que valorar a los medios de comunicación en su diversidad y con sus diferentes perfiles.
The president and the Mexican society should actually consider the value that the journalists have in the country.
Creo que López Obrador no es un presidente que vaya a ejercer censura como lo hicieron otros presidentes en México.
I don't think that López Obrador will apply his censorship as other Mexican presidents have done in the past.
Pero no todo depende del presidente.
But it's not everything up to the president.
En México, como en otros lugares del mundo,
in Mexico, just like in other places of the world,
hay grandes poderes empresariales.
There are also very big company powers
que controlan medios de comunicación.
That take control on the media.
Y que esos poderes afectan el libre ejercicio de las ideas.
And these companies have influence on the freedom of expression.
¿Existen también otros poderes locales?
There is another local powers.
Políticos y criminales.
Political and criminal.
Que afectan directamente hoy en día la libertad de prensa.
That have a direct control over the liberty of expression, the freedom of expression.
Llevamos muchos años con periodistas asesinados.
There have been many killing of journalists.
Y en los últimos meses ya con un nuevo gobierno federal.
And in the past few months, even though with the new president.
Ha habido asesinatos de periodistas en diferentes lugares de México.
There still have been murders of journalists in different places in Mexico.
No se le pueden atribuir al presidente mexicano.
We cannot charge those murders to the president.
Pero hay una realidad que persiste.
But there is a reality that's still present.
Es decir, el cambio político federal.
So the political change, this federal political change.
Por sí mismo no puede resolver de inmediato estos problemas.
This change of president by itself cannot solve the problem.
Sin embargo, hay una expectativa enorme.
But there is hope. There is some expectation.
Para que este presidente y una sociedad que votó un cambio.
For this president and the society who chose him.
En algún momento podamos dar un cambio cualitativo.
That we hope to eventually have a qualitative change.
En la calidad de la vida democrática.
In the quality of democracy.
En donde los periodistas podamos hacer nuestro trabajo.
Where journalists could do our work.
En libertad.
In freedom.
Con seguridad.
With security, safe.
Y debiendo nuestro trabajo a las audiencias y no a los poderes establecidos.
And being able to communicate our work to the audience and not to these political powers.
Hay un desafío enorme para México.
It's a big challenge for Mexico.
So, thank you, Carmen. There is a mountain of unsolved issues in Mexico, some that you just quoted, and of course, all of them covered by impunity. Some of them, not all, connected to drug trafficking, but we hear a crazy number of feminicides, mass killings, mass graves, forced disappearances. At the same time, there is a group of documentary filmmakers like you, Juliana, Everardo González, Tatiana Hueso, who are really keeping the pace and telling the stories. They do not decay and keep filming. And I wonder if you, journalists and filmmakers, because we documentary makers also work with reality as the basis of our work. Do you share the motivations? Do you work together? Do you know each other? Or are you walking in different paths? How is it in Mexico? And this question is for you both, the filmmaker and the journalist.
Of course, we are inspired by the journalist's work. I mean, we are reading the news every day and all the time. I am really obsessed. However, we work in different rhythms. They work really fast, and everything is already in the past as they are showing it to us. And we work with that material in order to make it eternal. I work especially in this film to preserve memory. So I wasn't really interested in the actuality of the events I was filming, but very interested in the perpetuity of the message I was giving.
It is clear that journalists are at risk in Mexico, but do you think that documentary makers are also at risk?
Well, hopefully, we haven't seen attacks as we have seen in other countries yet. However, filmmakers, student filmmakers, have been killed in Guadalajara, and that's very shocking. They come from the countryside, and but they were learning how to do this, and this is. Muy grave. This is really, really bad. I mean, maybe people as Everardo and Tatiana have the spotlight, and the spotlight protects you, but we need several voices, and voices that are maybe not yet that known to be able to speak.
Which is probably the same case for you, like you are also in the spotlight, Carmen, and that spotlight somehow protects you. But who are the journalists that get killed in Mexico? The ones reporting for small newspapers deep inside the states.
Sí, creo que para hablar de la integridad física de una persona, de un periodista en México, ayuda a la exposición misma.
I think to talk about the physical integrity of a journalist in Mexico, that exposition, the public exposition, helps you, of course.
Pienso, quiero creer que mi trabajo público es mi mayor protección.
I think and I want to believe that my public work is my biggest protection.
Me parece que el público aprecia el trabajo de los periodistas.
I want to believe that the public appreciates the works of the journalists.
Y si logras construir una audiencia que sigue tu trabajo.
And if you are able to build up an audience that follows you,
de alguna manera acaba siendo tu propia protección.
They are your own protection.
O eso quiero creer.
Or at least that's what I want to believe in.
And what are the particularities of being a female filmmaker or a female journalist in a country that is so machista? I don't know the word in English. As Mexico, what are the particular challenges that you are facing when you perform your profession?
I'm going to quote her because I asked her this during an interview we did for the film, and I believe the same as a woman filmmaker. As a professional, when you're a woman in Mexico, you have to prove not only you're intelligent, but you have to prove that you're not stupid. And men don't have to go through that, so we have a handicap in that sense, and I believe it is the same for both jobs.
Bueno, sí, creo que el tema del machismo sigue siendo un problema mundial. En algunos lugares más grave que en otros.
I think that machism is still a big problem in some places, even a heavier problem than in others.
En México hay una franja todavía importante de población con carga machista.
In Mexico there are some specific areas with a big macho culture.
Y les cuesta trabajo aceptar que una mujer pueda opinar, decir, dirigir cualquier cosa.
And it's very difficult for them to accept that a woman could have their own voice and opinion and decide to take decisions.
En el documental pudimos observar algunos mensajes de los que hemos recibido de ataques desde las redes sociales.
In the documentary, you see some of the messages that we receive via social media.
Muchos de estos ataques tienen carga sexual.
Many of these attacks are sexually, it has a sexual load.
Y se trata de herir y de dañar a una persona, en este caso a una mujer, con agresiones que no se harían en contra de un hombre.
And the purpose of these messages is exactly to attack a woman in a way that a man would never be attacked on that way.
Hemos logrado muchas cosas, también hay que decirlo.
We have to also sign that we have some achievements.
Hoy en México hay periodistas mujeres muy poderosas, muy importantes.
Right now in Mexico we have a very strong and powerful women journalists.
mujeres icónicas como Lidia Cacho, por ejemplo.
Lidia Cacho, for example, who is like an icon.
Que hoy mismo está fuera del país porque ha recibido agresiones nuevamente.
Who has to be at this moment outside of Mexico because she has been arrested.
Una valiente periodista que ha hecho investigaciones muy fuertes en relación a redes de poder que protegen explotación sexual, por ejemplo, infantil.
A very brave journalist who did some investigations about pedophile cases in the country.
Que ha escrito libros como Los demonios del Edén.
Who has written books as the Los demonios del Edén, The Demons of the Paradise, of the Eden.
Hace algunos años.
Some years ago.
Y eso significó para ella un ataque, muchos ataques judiciales. Hemos vivido juntas en tribunales.
And that meant for her many right issues, like court right laws issues, rechtsaken. Court cases, many trials, and we have been together in many of those court cases together.
Hoy Lidia Cacho ha logrado llegar hasta la justicia internacional.
Lidia Cacho managed to reach international right.
Y le han dado la razón en relación a lo que ha publicado.
And she got somehow a positive reaction about her publications.
Ha logrado que se giren órdenes de aprehensión en contra de quienes la secuestraron y torturaron hace algunos años.
She managed to get some case in order to for the people who kidnapped her and abused her. She managed to start a case against those people to be prosecuted.
Pero no han sido detenidas las personas responsables.
But they still are free.
Y ella ha recibido nuevas amenazas y la han obligado a salir del país.
And she has received new threatenings and she must flee of the country.
Así que desde aquí le mando un abrazo a Lidia Cacho, que está en una circunstancia doble. Por un lado ha ganado con la justicia, pero por otro lado ha tenido que salir del país otra vez.
So from here I send all my regards to her because in one side she got the right to fight for what she was fighting, but on the other side she had to still leave the country.
Quiero hablar de Lidia porque es un caso de una mujer periodista muy importante. Hablo de otras mujeres periodistas y por eso digo que hemos ganado muchas batallas en el periodismo las mujeres. También hemos vivido tragedias como el asesinato de Miroslava Breach.
I want to talk about Lidia because this is a clear example of another woman who is a journalist, but I would like to also mention the case of
Miroslava Breach, una periodista de Chihuahua que fue asesinada.
She is also another woman journalist from Chihuahua in Mexico who was assassinated.
Por investigar la relación del poder político local en Chihuahua.
Because she was doing some research about the political power in Chihuahua.
Con el crimen organizado.
With the organized crime.
Miroslava fue asesinada y forma parte de esas mujeres que han dado su, en este caso, su vida por el periodismo en México.
Miroslava Breach was assassinated because she was involved into these investigations and she was somebody who gave her life for journalism in Mexico.
Hablando pues de mujeres en México periodistas, menciono a ellas, pero hay otras mujeres. Probablemente los últimos años del periodismo en México han estado marcados por el trabajo de mujeres muy fuertes.
So I mentioned these cases, but I know that there is other cases that in Mexico have been marked by this journalism done by women.
Que han vencido al machismo.
That they managed to fight against the macho culture.
Y han hecho valer su trabajo.
And they have managed also to give a voice to their work.
And do you believe, Carmen, that documentary cinema can change realities? I'm thinking about the particular case of the students of the Tech de Monterrey who were killed. They were excellent students and they were accused by the military that they were apparently drug trafficking, but that was of course not true. And there was this film, Hasta los Dientes, and it provoked a public excuse from the government. What is your relationship with documentary cinema? Do you see it really as a tool to move things?
Creo que los documentales, el cine en general, es una expresión muy poderosa, muy influyente. No sé si para cambiar la realidad, pero para contribuir notablemente a cambiar la realidad, sin duda que está trabajos como este.
I think documentary is a very powerful tool in order to change the reality, especially if we look at documentaries like this one.
Es como el periodismo, la literatura, el arte, son expresiones humanas que inciden fuertemente en la vida de las personas.
Compared to journalism, art and other human ways of expression that have influences in human lives.
Y sin duda son una herramienta para cambiar las realidades.
And for sure they are a tool to change the realities.
Crean conciencia.
They create conscience.
Sacuden a las personas.
They shake the reality of people.
Ponen el dedo en la llaga.
They go to the point.
Son herramientas enormes para una sociedad.
They are great tools for a society.
Before opening the room for the audience, I have a last question for Juliana, which is regarding the voice, your text, because it's such beautiful text that I would not like to go out from this room without knowing how you write it. What was your process? Did you kept a diary? How all these ideas that end up being such a strong narration came and got a shape?
It was a long process in the editing room. It didn't start before, even though I knew that a voice was going to be written and recorded. And the beginning was a little bit hard because I had to find the tone, and this was maybe the most difficult for me. And my editor, Yael Biton, I did this work with her. She suggested for me to get inspired in literature, and that's what I did. And I found and I read this very powerful book about Javier Sicilia, a Mexican poet who lost his son during the drug war. And it's very, very painful. I wasn't able to read it till the end, but just to start feeling Javier's words really got me into this pain that we feel as Mexicans. And this was the beginning. Then, of course, other authors came. And I revisited George Orwell, of course, and Octavio Paz. He's been a reference to me since a long time. I also inspired. I was also inspired by him for my first film, and then it's just a job of writing and trying, and then coming back and trying again, and recording with your iPhone and try it with the images and try to find out the best words.
Well, you succeeded. So now let's open for questions. Emily has a microphone, and who would like to start? Yes. Okay. You and then you.
So it's the guy there.
Yes. Uh-huh. And number two is who?
And then.
Yes.
Primero, muchas gracias por el trabajo que hacen. I think there's no doubt that we all know that Mexico is corrupt and that the drug trafficking causes a lot of violence. What I'm wondering with this documentary is if it puts Mexico as an independent country, without making any connections to a global trafficking system. So, for example, England is one of the biggest users of cocaine, and I see this image of Enrique Peña with the Queen being friends and being happy. And I'm wondering that this is dangerous because people in Europe find themselves very innocent and not complicit to the violence that is happening in Latin America and in Mexico. And I'm wondering how this documentary doesn't add to that.
Who's your question for?
Anyone.
Thank you.
Well, it's a complex question because if you start reflecting about the issue of violence in Mexico, of course you can go very, very far. The case of the 43 students is one of those examples. It leads, if you really go into the what happened to them, it leads to Chicago. It leads to the United States, where the drug is being bought and sniffed and injected. So yes, of course, the subject of the film wasn't this one. It was the context, and it was very clear for me that we couldn't speak about Mexico without speaking about the drug cartel situation. So it is there, but it is there as a very complex issue, because there's a lot we know and a lot we don't know, and that there's a lot that has to be done, and we as a country totally depend on what's happening in the other countries that buy the drug in order to pacify our country.
Es muy fuerte ver cómo vi en el trayecto un puesto donde vendían paletas de marihuana aquí.
It was for me very shocking to see here in Amsterdam a shop where they sell lollipops made of marijuana.
Estuve a punto de comprar.
I was about to buy some.
Pero pensé que en México me detendrían en el aeropuerto.
That I will probably get caught in Mexico as soon as I come in.
Y sería penoso ir a la cárcel por esa razón.
And that would be very stupid to go to jail because of the lollies.
Así que no lo hice.
So I didn't do it.
Pero me sirve la escena para decir que hay una enorme hipocresía en el mundo.
But actually, this is a picture that I take to say that there is a big hypocrisy in the world.
Hay grandes mercados y grandes negocios criminales.
There's huge markets and huge criminal businesses.
Y gran contradicción.
And there is a great contradiction.
Vemos que en lugares como este puede haber una apertura.
We see that in places like this there is some opening.
Y países como México ponen los muertos.
And in countries like Mexico, we see the dead people.
Decenas de miles de muertos en el caso mexicano.
Thousands of dead people in Mexico.
Claramente el tema está en la prohibición, y claramente hay un gran debate internacional sobre cómo frenar el negocio criminal que trae enormes cantidades de violencia.
Clearly, this has to do with the prohibition of the business and how to avoid the thousands of victims as a result of these practices.
México ha ido a paso muy lento en su propia regulación sobre el tema.
Mexico has been very slow in the regulation process about this.
Pero tenemos claramente un problema mundial que tiene que cruzar por un debate sobre cómo revertimos un fenómeno de esta naturaleza.
But we do have a world problem. It's an issue worldwide about how do we can revert this problem.
Por lo pronto, México, al tomar una estrategia en los últimos años, en los últimos 18 años de combate bélico al crimen organizado.
At least Mexico took this position in the past 18 years about armed response to this organized crime.
El resultado ha sido contraproducente.
The result has not been what was expected, actually.
Hemos gastado enorme cantidad de dinero público en armas.
We have given away lots of money in weapons.
Ha habido miles de muertos.
There have been thousands of dead people.
Y los cárteles poderosos se hicieron más poderosos.
And the cartels are even now more powerful than before.
Y se desató un fenómeno mayor de corrupción en el territorio.
And now the corruption is even bigger than before.
Claramente la estrategia fue equivocada.
So this is a clear sign that the strategy was not the correct one.
El nuevo gobierno plantea cambiar la estrategia.
The new government is proposing to change the strategy.
Pero el monstruo ya es demasiado grande.
But the monster is already too big.
Tiene que darse un cambio estructural y no puede ser más que cambiando las reglas del juego.
So there, here we need a structural change, and that is not achieved by only changing the rules in the game.
Y seguiremos viendo escenas como la de Enrique Peña Nieto con la reina Isabel en esta gran contradicción sobre el tema.
And we will keep on seeing the pictures and the films as we see in the documentary from the former president Peña Nieto with the Queen Elizabeth, which is very contradictory.
There was another question down here somewhere. Yes. I can't reach all the way over there, so I'll just hand over the microphone.
And in the meantime, who would like to make the next one?
You.
Okay.
I have a question for Carmen. I can't ask it in Spanish. But I, in my personal environment, was somebody who was a whistleblower, and I was always amazed by the fact that so many different influences are taking part, political, non-political, people who go to you and threaten you. And what I wanted to ask Carmen, how did you find an inner strength to deal with all this? Because sometimes it can be very fearful to encounter this kind of threats. On the other side, I must say, for this person I know, there were also some help, there was help, and people were supporting this person. So I want to know how she deals with it personally, on a personal level, because I saw that it's very difficult to deal with this kind of different influences, which you don't, sometimes you don't know the people who threaten you.
No es fácil tener este tipo de amenazas, algunas más claramente identificables, otras en donde no sabes quién está detrás de la amenaza. Por ejemplo, cuando entraron a nuestras oficinas, en estas imágenes en donde entraron 5 individuos a romper las puertas y a llevarse una computadora de nuestra unidad de investigaciones especiales y no robar nada más, sino solo eso, son señales de intimidación.
It's not easy to deal with this kind of threatenings. There is some on different. There is different threatenings on different levels. But in this documentary, you see very clear how these 5 people break into the office. They take 1 computer. They don't take any other thing around. They just go for the computer. So this feels as an intimidation.
Como periodistas, bueno, preguntas cómo manejamos las amenazas. En este caso, que era una clara amenaza. Pues fuimos a presentar una denuncia con cierto grado de ingenuidad.
As a journalist, in order to react to this action, we actually went to make to denounce this, to just make a report about this, what happened, very thinking very naively about what we were about to do.
Ingenuidad, pero fuimos a presentarla y desde luego no ha pasado nada.
We made this report, and not knowing what was going to happen, actually it hasn't happened anything up to now.
Bueno, sí pasó. El expediente que se abrió por la denuncia que nosotros presentamos por este allanamiento a nuestras oficinas, la Procuraduría de la Ciudad de México lo que hizo fue filtrar el expediente con todos nuestros datos personales.
So basically what happened with the report that we made about the what happened to us in the office, it was that the court who was supposed to take care of the case made it somehow
leaked.
Leaked.
With the personal information.
La Procuraduría entregó filtró el expediente a una publicación de espectáculos.
They leaked this report to like a publisher of a show business.
Sí, to a magazine, a show magazine.
Al final, el gran tema es el miedo, y creo que hay que tenerle respeto al miedo, que es una condición del ser humano. Y cuando digo tener respeto al miedo, significa que hay que fortalecer tus protocolos, hacer mejor tus trabajos de investigación, pero no permitir que te inmovilice. Ese es el gran reto. Que no desestimar el miedo, no hacer creer que no te importa el miedo, porque importa, pero que sirva para reforzar tu propio trabajo y no permitir que te inmovilice.
I think we have to have respect with fear, but you need to strengthen your protocol. You need to find new ways to do better research. But you don't have to let them, and you don't have to let fear paralyze you.
Hello, my name is Miriam. Thank you for being here. My question is for Carmen. So, as from the movie and from Juliana, you are the pride of a nation, and I would like to ask you, looking back at your career or your work today, what are you the most proud of? You know, was there a moment or the work or a report?
He tenido muchos momentos muy importantes en mi trabajo, sobre todo cuando una investigación tiene impacto.
I've had many very important moments in my job, especially when research is a success.
O algo sucede con lo que publicaste.
Or something happened after you have done a publication.
Tenemos varias historias, por ejemplo, cuando investigamos a un líder político del PRI.
We have many success stories. For example, one time we were doing some research about a political leader from the PRI. The PRI is one of the Mexican right wing political parties.
El partido dominante por 70 años en México.
That was the party that was in power for 70 years in the country.
Este líder financiaba o pagaba una red de prostitución con dinero de ese partido.
And this political leader was paying a network of corruption with money from the political party.
Enganchaba a mujeres jóvenes.
So he would lock women, young women,
para trabajar en ese partido.
To come and work for him, for his party.
Y al final el trato era para que dieran servicio sexual a él y probablemente a otras personas.
And actually what was after all of that was just like basically to sexually abuse of those women, to give sexual services to him and to other people of the political party.
Todo eso con dinero público y dentro de las instalaciones de ese partido político.
All of that with public money and in the facilities of the political party itself.
Esa investigación fue muy importante porque con una reportera disfrazada.
That research was very important because we had an undercover reporter
que se vistió provocativamente para pedir trabajo.
She dressed up in a provocative way in order to get a job.
Y una grabadora en la bolsa.
And she had a tape recorder in her purse.
Con eso y con otras informaciones importantes.
With some of that and some other important information,
pudimos demostrar que sucedía eso.
We could prove that that was the practices that were happening.
El mismo día que publicamos ese trabajo,
the same day that this investigation was published,
ese partido político tuvo que pedir la renuncia de ese líder político.
This political party had to ask for the resignment of this political person.
No duró demasiado el efecto porque después lo vimos operar nuevamente.
The effect didn't last for long because later on we saw him again back into these practices.
Este es un caso de varios en donde tu trabajo significa algo y tiene una repercusión importante.
This is one example in between other cases that you realize that your work is important and has effects that are also important for the people.
La investigación que hicimos sobre la Casa Blanca, que es parte de este reportaje, de este documental.
The research we've done about the White House that's a part in this documentary.
Significó un golpe de censura para nosotros, sí.
It was a censorship strike for us.
Pero también significó la posibilidad de mostrarle a un país.
But it also gave us the possibility to show to a country.
Un ejemplo de lo que pasaba en un gobierno esencialmente corrupto.
An example of what was happening in this corrupt government.
Creo que este tipo de investigaciones incidieron en una sociedad de alguna manera.
I believe that this kind of research had some effect in the society.
Que decidió acudir a las urnas para dar un vuelco político en México.
That motivated the people to go and vote in the new elections.
We have time for, okay, a couple more questions. So your question, and then yours, and then we will have to close.
Okay. I saw two hands.
Okay, yeah,
the man in the shirt.
Yeah, he was the first one.
Okay. Then we'll move upwards. Yes, and we'll take them all in one go.
Hello. First of all, congratulations on the documentary. I think we appreciate a lot the opportunity you give us to see these images and to hear about what's happening in Mexico. I would like to ask Carmen a question. Apologies if it's a bit rude. So I would like to know if you have ever thought about actually entering into politics to change the sides from journalism and going within political actions. So I know you have a very strong voice in Mexico, and I think a lot of people follow you, and I mean, I just know you have also a very intellectual table. You have a very critical mind, and everything you have said is out of reason. So I think it's people look for that now in a country like Mexico.
Okay, we'll move on to the next question and then we'll come back to yours.
Thanks. This is a question for Carmen too. I know that at least 1,000 of journalists have been killed since the change of regime in Mexico. Does it feel safer now to be a journalist?
There's one more very urgent question, I believe, right in the back. And that's the very last one.
Hola, Carmen. Una pregunta nada más. ¿Tú crees que hay corrupción en el periodismo también?
The question is if you believe if there is also corruption in journalism.
Son tres preguntas, lo cual me permite contestar las que yo quiera. Me voy a brincar la primera.
There are three questions, so may I take the freedom of just answer whichever I like. I'm going to go for the first one.
No, bromeo. Por lo pronto no tengo intención de cambiar mi papel de periodista para participar directamente en la política. En este momento creo que mi trabajo está claramente identificado con la tarea periodística y así lo pienso seguir haciendo. Entiendo que en algunos momentos los periodistas o las personas que tenemos una presencia pública en algunos casos pueden pasar a hacer la política. No sé si haya traducción fácil, pero
I'm not planning at this moment to move from journalism to politics, but I understand that in some cases some public figures get into politics.
En México dirían, no es lo mismo ser borracho que cantinero.
In Mexico we will say it's not the same to be a drunk man than to be a waiter, a bartender.
Bueno, es todo un tema. Sobre la seguridad de los periodistas, efectivamente en este sexenio que empieza, no ha cumplido un año todavía.
Talking about the security for journalists in this presidential term that haven't been a year on the presidency yet.
Lamentablemente han ocurrido asesinatos de periodistas, es decir, continúa este fenómeno en México.
There has been journalists murdered, so basically this problem is still going on.
Lo cual quiere decir que los fenómenos de criminalidad, de corrupción y de agresión a la prensa prevalecen en buena parte de la República Mexicana.
So criminality, corruption, and aggression to journalists are still present in a big part of the Mexico.
Y que cambiar un presidente no es suficiente para un país.
And only to change the president is not enough for the country and for this issue.
La responsabilidad de un presidente es muy grande.
The responsibility of a president is very big.
Pero para pensar que México va a cambiar, tenemos que contar con todos los mexicanos y cambiar de una manera dramática en lo que corresponde a la relación del gobierno, la sociedad y la criminalidad.
But to really think that Mexico is going to change as a whole, we need to consider all the Mexicans in a political society and in a more general way.
I'm sorry, I've been asked to cut you short because our photographer has to leave soon. Is that right? No?
Sorry? Is there corruption in journalism?
Corrupción en los periodistas. Corrupción en periodistas. Desde luego que sí. Desde luego que México tiene un problema de mucho tiempo atrás, en donde la prensa o una parte de la prensa ha sido un elemento del propio sistema político. México ha vivido décadas de control en todos los sentidos. El sistema político mexicano históricamente ha sido un sistema de controles múltiples.
There is, of course, corruption in journalists. This has been for decades. There is a control from the political system. It's an historic way, in a historic way.
El escritor Vargas Llosa, llamó al sistema mexicano la dictadura perfecta.
And Vargas Llosa called the Mexican system the perfect dictatorship.
Porque daba la apariencia de un cierto sistema democrático sin serlo.
Because appeared as a certain democratic system without being it.
Y ese sistema iba de la mano de control de los trabajadores, de corporativismo y de control de la prensa en México.
And that system was taken into consideration all the control of the workers and control of the journalists.
México ha vivido una larga transición, esperemos que hacia la democracia.
Mexico has been in a long way, in a long path to democracy. Let's hope that's to democracy.
Y una parte muy importante para lograrlo es que los periodistas no reciban favores o beneficios de un poder político que los ha alimentado históricamente.
And what's important for that is that journalists doesn't get any kind of compensation from the government side or from the other
Recientemente
parties.
En este nuevo gobierno se dio a conocer, por ejemplo, una lista.
And not so long ago, with this under this new government, there was a list public
de periodistas que habían recibido dinero de la propia presidencia. Lo cual, pues, te habla un poco de la dinámica existente. No ahora, sino tiempo atrás.
There was a list published of journalists who got money from the government in order to publish some.
Se le llama chayoteros a esos periodistas.
And we call them chayoteros in Mexico, those kind of journalists.
Si tienen dos horas, se los explico.
If you will have 2 hours, I could explain that to you.
El fotógrafo no lo permitiría nunca.
The photographer wouldn't allow that because he has to go home.
Okay, thank you so much. Gracias, Carmen. Gracias, Juliana. Thank you. Yeah, and I would also like to acknowledge the presence of the team of the film because filmmaking is a collective work. So please also a big applause for all the team who is here. We'll be right back.